All About Insurance on BCTV is supported by the Chester Perfetto Agency.
Agency. We are your one-stop shop for all of your insurance needs, located in Wyomissing off of Broadcasting Road. Today I'm here with Jennifer Burton, and we are both going to talk to you about Medicare and health insurance updates for April and for 2021. There's a lot changing, particularly with health care, so we have a lot to update you with. So let's begin. We are proud to be part of Chester Perfetto Agency, and this year we are celebrating our 50th year in business. And we would like to thank you, Berks County and beyond, for your trust and loyalty in our agency over the last 50 years. And speaking of an agency, we are an independent agency, which allows us to give you a choice. We represent many insurance companies, so you'll get a complete comparison of what's available to you. We work for you, our clients, and not an insurance company. That allows us to provide you with more options and more competitive benefits and rates. Our goal is education. That way you feel confident you have the coverage you need. And after you get a policy with our agency, we are your consultants for the lifetime of that policy. We will continue to review your plans and make recommendations to keep your coverage current for your changing needs. And we work as a team. We have different departments for all different insurances, and we are try to be the experts in our department. So right now, Jennifer's going to get us started with health insurance and updates with Pennsylvania.
Thanks, Jess. So if you haven't heard by now, Pennsylvania has moved to their own state-based health exchange. So Penny has replaced healthcare.gov. So if you reside in Pennsylvania and you do need health insurance, you must go through Penny. You can no longer use healthcare.gov. But if you are on Penny or you are in need of health insurance, they have extended the open enrollment through August 15th of 2021 for anybody that is in need. Already over 337,000 people have enrolled for 2021 alone. We can help you navigate Penny and explain the plans that are available to you. From what I've seen, people have been a little bit overwhelmed by the application process. We can get you through the application process and then what plans are available to you and what is going to be a good fit for you. If you would need insurance after open enrollment ends in August, you can still get insurance if you have a qualifying event. A qualifying event would be if you are losing your employer coverage or if you're currently through COBRA, if your COBRA coverage would end. If you get married or divorced, or if you need to add a dependent, you may need to show proof of your qualifying event in order for your coverage to begin. The biggest change that is happening right now with Penny are because of the American Rescue Plan that was signed into law last month. The American Rescue Plan is the largest expansion since the Affordable Care Act back in 2010. The plan increases eligibility for and the amount of tax credits for Pennsylvanians at all income levels for both 2021 and 2022. What that means is if you have not previously qualified for assistance, you may now. Or if you're already enrolled, you may qualify for a higher level of assistance. 9 out of 10 people will qualify for some level of financial assistance. The American Rescue Plan will remove the subsidy cliff, as they refer to it, So that means there's not an income limit threshold now when you go to apply through Penny. There is now an 8.5% cap on your healthcare premiums for certain plans, and that cap is based on your household income. So what this means is it's a great time to review your coverages. If you're already enrolled, this is an opportunity that you can go back in, look at your plans. If you're happy with your coverage, that's great. If you're not, you can go in, look at your plans, make any changes that you might want to make. You can move to a new plan. There might be a greater level of financial assistance available to you now through the American Rescue Plan and those changes. So it is a great time to review your coverage. And you can do that again through August 15th. If you have been deemed eligible for unemployment for at least 1 week, it only had to be 1 week through 2021, you will get the maximum amount of assistance that Penny can offer you for 2021. So if you have not applied, I would greatly encourage you to apply through Penny. It can save people thousands of dollars for this year. Another big part of this through the American Rescue Plan, if you have been on healthcare.gov for previous years and you received an overpayment in a subsidy or the tax credits that help you pay for that monthly premium, and you're doing your taxes and it shows that you've received an overpayment, you do not have to pay that back for 2020 when you're filing your 2021 taxes. I'm not sure on how they're doing that paperwork. That would be something you need to check with your tax professional on how to get that filed. Another part of the American Rescue Plan that affected healthcare was with people that qualify for COBRA. If you have COBRA coverage available to you due to involuntary termination or reduction of hours that caused you to lose your employer health coverage, the cost of your COBRA benefits is eligible to be covered from April 1st of this year through September 30th. Even if you initially passed on your COBRA coverage due to it being not affordable or it was just something that you did not want to participate in, you may now go back and elect to participate in that coverage. That may mean you had a gap, and that's okay. You can still go back and enroll. You would want to contact the benefit administrator of your health plan in order to process those changes and to take advantage of that benefit. If you do choose to elect that COBRA coverage and the benefit period of April through September where you will have those benefits covered, Penny is going to offer a special enrollment period when September 30th comes that you will then be eligible to enroll through Penny and get coverage from October 1st on. And with COBRA, you can actually remain on COBRA for up to 8 months past your 65th birthday before you enroll in Medicare. If those benefits are appealing to you, if it's cost effective to you, that is something you might want to think about. Those are not the same benefits that I refer to that would be covered if you were terminated or lost your coverage that are being covered due to the American Rescue Plan. And that will lead us into Medicare with Jess.
Thanks, Jen. So what is changing with Medicare and what do you need to know for this year? One big change that is occurring right now for members who have certain Part D prescription drug plans, if you enrolled in the plan Indy Health for your Part D prescription drug plan for 2021, you have to take action by the end of July. Plans under Indy Health have been terminated as of March 1st of 2021. The reason for that, Indy Health could not project future earnings. And when that occurs, in insurance purposes, the state where the company was located in Arkansas took over the health insurance company to help protect its members to remain covered. So if you have Indy Health, you currently have a plan through the state program, but that is changing to Humana as of May 1st. Humana is a very good company and has many plans available, but it may not be the best plan for your mix of prescriptions. We can help sort through the over 30 plus options for Part D and find the best plan for the mix of prescriptions you take and the pharmacy that you prefer to use. This change takes effect May 1st, so if you have Indy Health, we strongly suggest making a change prior to May 1st, but you do have until the end of July to make a final change. So when you turn 65 and become eligible for Medicare, many people opt to take it, but others opt to wait and not take it. What would determine that situation really depends on your work status and also the status of your spouse. If you are continuing to work and you're covered through an employer plan or covered under your spouse's employer plan, you do not need to enroll in Medicare. We do suggest getting at least Part A when you turn 65, but that does not affect the employer coverage. If you have individual health insurance through an insurance company or through Penny, you should enroll in Medicare when you turn 65. If you do pay a portion of a premium with the employer coverage you have, you may want to compare prices and benefits if you pay for a portion of that plan. And how you enroll in Medicare is now becoming a little more streamlined online. Social Security does recommend you apply online, and you can start by going to medicare.gov. By scrolling down under Resources, you click Apply for Medicare, and that will direct you to the Social Security website where you can sign up for Medicare. You can also call the local Social Security office here in Reading, and they will set up a phone appointment with you if you prefer to talk over the phone and have assistance in the enrollment. Please give yourself time to enroll in Medicare. It's really strongly encouraged that you enroll in any type of health insurance, including Penny, at least 30 to 60 days prior to needing the coverage to begin. You may need to provide proof of certain things, and by getting different paperwork available, it can take up to 2 months for your Medicare to take effect. Under the Medicare program, you have two options to get yourself covered. The first option is to keep your Medicare A and B as your primary coverage, which covers 80% of your medical expenses, and get a Medicare supplement that will cover the difference. With a Medicare supplement, you also need a Part D prescription plan to help cover prescriptions. Or the other option is to go with a Part C Medicare Advantage plan. Under Medicare Advantage, this replaces your Medicare A and B and becomes your primary coverage. The plan does have copays and in some circumstances deductibles to meet. And what Mr. Profeto used to say, it is a good plan if you never have to use it because the plans are less expensive, but they have higher out-of-pocket costs. If you have a Medicare supplement plan and have been enrolled in the plan for at least 3 years or longer, it's important to review the plan because you may be paying a lot more than you need to for the same coverage you can get with a different company. The benefits for Medicare supplement plans are the same no matter what company you choose, and the only difference is price. Why pay more for the same coverage? So under Medicare supplement plans, on the screen are rates of examples of the best plan available under Medicare, Plan F, and another very popular plan that is a little less expensive, Plan N. The younger you are, the lower the premiums, and of course, the older you are, the higher the premiums. But a Plan F for a female can be as low as $153 per month or $160 if you're a male at 70 years old. And a Plan N is as low as $90 per month for females and $100 for males 70 years old. And now we're going to talk a little bit about dental insurance and if you think it's worth covering your teeth.
Yeah, Jess, one of the big questions that I get is, I've had dental insurance with my employer, and if I have the option of continuing it.
Mm-hmm.
And we do prefer Delta Dental. They are the most preferred provider that I have found with a lot of dentists in our area. And Delta Dental has two great PPO plans that we work with. Like I said, that has a really extensive network. So with their basic plan, it's just under $18, it's $17.89 per month per member. So that would be for each of you if you are a family or a couple. You do get your cleanings and exams right away. That is from day one. They will cover you. And then after that, you have kind of a limited benefit with the basic plan. They will cover 50% of your basic services. Basic services are going to be your fillings, simple extractions, and they will cover up to $1,000 of that benefit per year. With their premium plan, that is $35.83 per member per month, and it has a significant amount more benefits to that plan. So with that, again, they will cover your cleanings and exams right away from day one. And then after that, they will cover your basic services, which again are those fillings and simple extractions. They have a 30-day waiting period. But after 12 months of a waiting period, they will also cover things like endodontics, which is your root canals, oral surgery, bridges, dentures, teeth whitening, which seems to be gaining some popularity, but is a much more comprehensive plan for people that are looking to have some dental work done or just want to be prepared for what might happen. And then vision is another popular question for people that, you know, don't have that incorporated with anything or have had that benefit and are now looking to see if it's something they can continue. So can you answer some questions on that one, Jess?
Absolutely. Vision benefits and vision insurance is very affordable. Many plans start at about $12 per month. The more expensive plans are still under $20. They do cover you for your routine refractive eye exam, which is the exam to tell you what your prescription is for your glasses or contacts. You do get an allowance toward glasses, lenses, and contacts either annually or every other year, depending on the plan. And after you reach those maximums, because glasses and contacts can be very expensive, you do get pretty significant discounts for other things such as specialty lenses, other types of contacts, and even LASIK surgery. And like I mentioned, they're very affordable plans that start around $12 per month. Why should you review your insurance plans? With Medicare and health insurance, many things change, typically on an annual basis, not only with your plan or the insurance company, but also your personal needs. The prices may change. Your health needs may change. Benefits may change, or new plans may be introduced. And why should you pay more for similar coverage? And for all types of insurance, not just your medical and health type needs, other reasons you should review your home or auto insurance, if you put additions on your home, change things, if you're afraid you're losing money in your 401k, there are other types of insurances out there that may benefit you to review. If there's changes with Mother Nature and the way things are different than 10 years ago, you may want to review the type of coverage you have just in case of a claim. And as more companies change and merge, new companies become available that are reputable and may save you money. Financial planning goes hand in hand with retirement and health insurance coverage for yourself and your family, as well as Medicare. If you're thinking about retiring, or if you just want to invest but you're afraid of what to do or of the different ups and downs of the market, and also if you don't have a lot of growth, you're looking for more growth, you may want to review your current financial plans And if you're retiring, you do have to take action if you have a 401k or pension. We have the experts available that can review you and review your plan and project what the future may hold. That way you can plan ahead so you know what to do when your retirement day comes. And Jen, please talk about life insurance.
Sure, Jess. With life insurance, it goes, again, hand in hand with financial planning and just being prepared for now and in the future. And we do have several plans available when it comes to life insurance. You have your final expense plans. These are affordable life insurance plans that are typically used by families for final expense planning, you know, with burials and paying off any debt that might remain. They're usually very easily obtained, very simple questions, and they're easily obtained policies, like I said. Then you have your guaranteed life insurance. These, again, don't really ask any health questions. They may have reduced benefits at the initial starting period, but after that period is over, your beneficiaries will receive your full death benefit. Not many people like to talk about life insurance, but it is something that we all will face, and it's something to think about even as you're younger, if you're getting married, if your family is expanding, you're buying a house, things to think about how your family will go on if by chance something unfortunately would happen to a member of your family, just to help keep them in your home or your children continuing with their education and things like that. So it's definitely something to think about.
Absolutely. And as you retire as well, if you had life insurance at work, you may be losing that coverage. So it would be very important to talk to somebody along with your retirement plans to review your life insurance.
Exactly. It's a benefit that a lot of people take for granted that they might not have. Yeah. Absolutely. Like you said, once they leave that coverage.
Thank you. And please, Jen, talk about travel insurance, because hopefully that's something that we'll all be able to use in the very near future.
Yeah, for sure. Travel is definitely picking up across the board as people are getting vaccinated and countries and states are lifting those restrictions. So Chester Perfetto is the parent company of Travel Safe Travel Insurance. Travel Safe was ranked the fourth best travel insurance company by Forbes last year back in 2020, which was a very exciting day for Travel Safe. But pre-COVID, 1 in 6 American travelers have been impacted by medical conditions, natural disaster, or carrier-caused delays. TravelSafe offers several different options to help ensure your trip. That would help with medical emergencies, delays if you missed your connecting flights, things like that, to help you recoup some of those costs. You can get up to 100% of your reimbursed trip costs, your trip interruption, or trip evacuations. So if you miss that flight, a connecting flight, your ship if you're going on a cruise, again, hopefully soon, or trip evacuations as bad weather would come in, things like that. You do have coverage for a medical emergency of up to $1 million for an accident or sickness, medical evacuation, or return of remains if a death occurs. Sometimes just some things that people don't think of is that they're covered by their health or their Medicare insurance.
Right.
And that might be true in certain circumstances, but not a lot. We always advise to get travel insurance, especially if you're traveling outside of the states. The premiums are very affordable. On average, it costs approximately 5 to 10% of your total trip cost. And Chester Perfetto is the only independent agency in the United States with our own travel insurance product. That's something that we're very, very proud of over here.
Absolutely. So. Thank you, Jen. And once again, we are the Chester Perfetto Agency. We're your one-stop shop for all of your insurance needs. Not only do we offer the insurance plans we talked about today, but we also have 401k, 403b, and IRA rollovers, auto and homeowners insurance, and that includes motorcycle insurance, boat insurance. So if you're getting out your fun things for the spring and summer, it's definitely a good time to shop the insurance because there are very competitive rates with the different companies. Business insurance, even if you're a one-man company, you need insurance. We have all types to cover you and your employees. That also includes group benefits for health insurance, dental, life insurance, our Medicare plans, life insurance for you and your family, and travel insurance. We offer free, no obligation quotes by email, by phone, and by face-to-face appointment. Thank you for listening to us this month, and we will talk to you next month. Have a great day.
Yay. All About Insurance on BCTV is supported by the Chester Profeto Agency.
I like these slides. Yeah. I was like...